Muslims act in compliance with their conscience, while the hypocrites act with their logic. The lives of Muslims and the hypocrites are completely different from each other in every detail. In this regard, one of the most important indications is that a believer acts with his conscience, whereas the hypocrite acts with his logic. Muslims listen to the voice of their conscience in every incident they experience, in every decision they make, in every step they take, in every word they utter, and in every thought and every choice they make. A hypocrite, on the other hand, is engaged in worldly intrigues and doing all of these things and acts based on the distorted logic through which he reasons out everything. In the soul of a human being, there are two forces engaging in a constant struggle, his conscience and his logic. Conscience always prevails in the soul of a Muslim. However, as the hypocrite does not act with the spirit of faith, he ignores his conscience due to some calculations, such as a fear of the future, the wish to earn people's consent, some ambition for a position or for authority, or perhaps some plans of treachery. However, at every moment God reveals himself to the conscience of people and sincere Muslims abide by their conscience. A Muslim stops acting in the habit of using his logic without employing his conscience. Contrary to this, if a person insists upon leading his life in line with his logic instead of the morality of the Quran, although he has faith in God, this would prevent him from having a sincere faith and make him adopt a hypocritical character. In the Quran, in Surah Ash-Shams, God states that the conscience is the inspiration of God. And the self in what proportioned it and inspired it with depravity or piety. He who purifies it has succeeded. He who covers it up has failed. Surat Ash-Shams, 7-10. When a Muslim abides by his conscience, he also takes many risks, which is only possible through having a deep faith. As the hypocrite is exceedingly fond of his comfort, he never undertakes an obligation of this kind. For instance, because he protects the downtrodden, a Muslim may suffer from a loss of property or even lose his job, his status, or the people around him. However, he acts in compliance with the approval of God. He opts for his approval, although his logic dictates that he protect himself. Darwinism, for example, is a worldwide antichrist movement under the protection of the British shadow state. However, Mr. Adnan Oktar has come up with an idea by himself and struggled against this antichrist system by means of scientific evidence. It is beyond question that he did this, aware of the fact that he could achieve that by the will of God and the power granted by God. He knew that it was not by his own power, but by the power of God. To accomplish this, he acted only with his conscience. If he employed his logic for that, he would not have accomplished anything. Logic destroys people. It darkens both their world and their afterlives. However, because the hypocrite fancies himself as very canny and acts hard-headed in such situations, he reckons that he can always stay ahead of the game. However, this mentality of the hypocrite dulls his conscience completely, pushes people away from him, and makes everything that he assumes is to his own advantage turn against him.